We have seen the relation between friction and coefficient of friction and normal reaction. In a plane surface, when an object is on it and it has got mass m, it is applying force downward mg, and in the return this surface in contact, it is applying a reactionary force which we call normal reaction, because this makes 90 degree angle. Now friction force is equal to mu into normal reaction. This is what we have studied, and here it is reaction is equal to what? If this force is mg, the reaction is also equal to mg. Now there is a different case. This is the inclined plane. On the inclined plane, an object is placed and it is pushing it. But in which direction? It has no concern with the direction of the plane. It is concerned with the earth, because earth is applying force on it, and it is always vertical. So this is the force on it, mg. Now when this applies the force here, and there is an obstruction in the form of this surface, it is pressing the surface. The surface is applying a force on it. Now any surface, when it applies force, it can apply force normal to it, normal to itself. Now this is the direction of the surface, and it applies force in this direction. So this is normal reaction. This is normal reaction here. And because normal, so we have to make a 90 degree and then make a reaction. So this is normal reaction by the surface. This is the direction of normal reaction. Now this mg, this is a force. This force can be divided into two forces at right angle to each other. And we know that how we can divide a vector. So we resolve this vector into two directions. One is this direction along this line, and one is this direction, which is at right angle to it. Now we are trying to find out this angle. Let us take this angle theta. This is the angle of inclination. Now on this line, this is perpendicular. On this line, this is perpendicular. Therefore, angle between the two lines is equal to the angle between the two perpendiculars. And with this theory, this is also angle theta. Now if this is angle theta and this is the force mg, the component of this force mg by the angle theta will be less than mg, and this is equal to mg cos theta. This we have done in vector resolutions. Now the other component of this mg is mg sin theta. Now what is meant by the components? Components that mg, which is acting due to gravity of the earth, we can consider as if there are two forces acting in place of one mg, and they work in the directions where we need them to work, where we want their calculation. And we want their calculation in this direction as well as in this direction, because whenever we resolve, we have to make two components at right angle to each other so that their sum is mg. Because the total force is mg, it is not possible that we take only mg sin theta and forget it. No, we have to take both, then only we have taken cognizance of mg. Okay, so mg is divided into two parts because their sum is mg. Now these are the components. Now what these components are doing? Mg cos theta is pressing this surface at normal direction, and in reply to that, this surface, according to third law, is pressing this object outward. So this mg cos theta generates a reaction, which is normal reaction because it is at right angle. Now on this body, mg cos theta is acting in this direction, normal reaction is acting at this direction, and this body is neither going up nor it is coming down. That means this normal reaction R is equal to mg cos theta. Okay, now we come to this mg sin theta. Mg sin theta is in this direction. If there is no force to balance it, then this will slide down. This will move. It will become an unbalanced force. So, one thing you should always remember, that which component of the mg, which component of the weight is responsible for moving the object. So, I will write it here, mg sin theta along incline is responsible for motion along surface. So, please always remember it. When this is angle theta, then it is mg sin theta which is trying to bring it down. Now, if nothing balances it, then it will pull it down. But the moment a motion starts, according to our principles and knowledge, a friction is developed between the two, and that friction is trying to stop it. Now, if the friction has succeeded to stop it, then what does that mean? That means the friction is equal to mg sin theta. If friction is equal to mg sin theta, then it will stop and it will stay, no motion will start. The force is balanced. Okay. Now, suppose this is the condition when it is at the verge of starting motion. That is the maximum value of friction. Okay. For any value of friction, force of friction is equal to mg sin theta. So, here we have friction normal reaction is equal to tangent theta. So, friction is equal to normal reaction into tan theta. No, we are not going to do that. We want to find out tangent theta, and this is tangent theta. Now, here, when the body will slide, what is the sliding condition? The sliding condition is when mg sin theta more than friction. If this become larger than friction, then this will slide down. Okay? Right. Now, what is the net force with which it will slide down? Net force of sliding down. Okay. First, we know the friction has a relation with normal reaction. Friction is equal to mu into normal reaction. In this case, normal reaction is this. In this case, normal reaction is not mg. In this case, normal reaction is mg cos theta. This we have done it. Okay. So, if this is normal reaction, then I will write it here mu mg cos theta. This is the friction. Now, what is the condition for sliding? Mg sin theta should be more than the friction. That means mg sin theta should be larger, equal or larger than mu into mg cos theta. Mg sin theta should be equal or larger to friction, and write value of friction here, mu mg cos theta here, mg mg is cancelled. So sin theta should be larger than mu cos theta. Take cos theta here, this will be tangent theta. Yes. So if tangent theta, theta is so large that tan theta is equal or larger than mu, then the body will start sliding down. This is the friction on the inclined plane, and this we have already done when we were doing angle of repose. Okay, now how much, if there is such situation, then how much force is required to push the body downward if it is not sliding? Okay, I push a body here. I keep a body here and I see it is not sliding down. Why? I know there is a friction here, that is why it is not sliding down. So I apply a force. Here mg sin theta is acting on it. Here is friction. How much is the friction? Friction is mu mg cos theta. This we have already done. Friction. Now, if it is not sliding down, then I have to apply an additional force on it so that it will slide. And I apply a force here. That force is F. Now it starts sliding. I want to find out how much is this force which is required to pull it down. Then F is equal to, now since it has started sliding down, I can write that F plus mg sin theta is equal to mu mg cos theta. So how much is F? The force required to pull it down is mu mg cos theta minus mg sin theta. Okay, you can take mg out. This is the force required to pull down. Now, second case, I want to push it up. If I want to push it up, then the situation is here. This is the box. Oh, this is angle alpha. Everywhere I should put alpha. No problem. You can do that. Now, here is an object. There is an incline with angle phi, and I put a box here. It is at rest and I want to push it up so that motion starts. This is very important. Please see, when I want to push it up, where is the intention of motion? Answer, intention of motion is for upward motion. If I want to move it in this direction, then what will be the direction of friction? Will it be same? Answer, no. Because if I have an intention to move up, then friction will be generated in opposite direction of the intention. So in this case, here is the friction. See, in this case, I am pulling it down. Where is the intention of motion? Downward. So where will be the force of friction? Upward. In this case, what is my intention? I want to pull it up and I apply a force. Where is the intention? Upward. So friction will automatically be downward. Now, because it is an incline, at every incline mg participate with a force mg sin theta in this direction. Okay, whether it is going up whether it is going down, the component of mg in this direction is always mg sin theta, and that is here mg sin theta. Mg sin, this is phi, so mg sin phi. It acts in this direction. Friction acts in this direction. I am applying force in this direction because I want to push it up. So this is force for upward motion. This was downward motion. Now, what is the equation here? Force for upward motion, the incline is equal to sum of the two. That is friction mu mg cos theta plus mg sin theta. And this is equal to mg mu cos phi plus sin phi. This is force, minimum force required. More than that will give it acceleration. So, minimum. See, the minimum force required to bring down the object is mg mu cos alpha minus. For taking up, same mu cos is there, but in place of minus, this is plus. Okay. Now, say the value of mu cos alpha, mg mu cos alpha in a particular case is 100, and this is, say, this is 60. Again, mu mg cos alpha friction is 100 and mg sin alpha is 60. 160. How much force I need to pull it down? Yes, you know it will be 40, because 60 is friction, 40 I apply, 100 is friction, and it will start sliding down. In this case, 60, 100. Okay. In this case, the moment I apply force here, this 100 friction comes into this direction, 100. This is 60. So, how much force I have to apply? Answer, I have to apply 160. 100 to counter the friction, 60 to counter mg sin theta. Therefore, I have to apply 160, then only it will go up. Please remember, what did you find the force to bring it down? In this case, it was 100 minus friction minus 60, and that was 40. If I want to push it up, then how much we have calculated? 160. Now, there is a large gap between the two. Suppose I apply a force of 100, then what will happen? 100 upward, it will not move up, because up motion start only at 160. Okay, I apply a force here. Okay, this is 40 in this direction, say minus 40. So, minus 40 to 160, what is the situation of this object? Minus 40, it will start coming down. Plus 160, it starts going up. And what are the forces between these two? This is zero line, this is minus 40, this is plus 160. If I apply this force, the body is going up. If I apply this force, the body is going down. What happens if I apply force in this range? Answer is, the object will not move. So, we have solved a question for what range of the force this body will not move. What is the range of that force? This up minus this. 160 minus minus 40. So, this will be 160 minus minus 40. This is equal to 200 is the range. 200 is the range for which this object will not move. Can we make it in these terms? Answer yes. This is for up, this is for down. Make a minus. So how much it will come? I will have to write it somewhere. Range for no motion. The range for no motion is, let us, this minus this. Mg is common. Mg is common. Inside, first I will write this mu. Let us suppose the angle is same, alpha. For this it will be mu cos alpha plus sin alpha, then minus these two terms. This is minus mu cos alpha, and this minus and minus will become plus sin alpha. Okay. Now you see mu cos alpha is cancelled. What we get is 2mg sin alpha is the range for which it will stay at this point, right? So this is how we get the force. Okay. So this is all about inclined plane, friction on the inclined plane, doing the calculation. If the object is moving on the inclined plane, then there has to be unbalanced force. How do we calculate that unbalanced force? Answer, force applied minus force of friction. That will give us the unbalanced force. And with that unbalanced force, we will do the calculation of mass into acceleration. That will give us the acceleration. So once we know how to calculate friction, we can always find out the remaining force. If friction at any place we have calculated 60 Newton and we are applying 100 Newton, then body will move with what force? Answer, 100 minus 60. With 40 Newton it will move. So net force will be 40, and according to that we will be calculating acceleration on that. Next we will see, in case of a wall, what is the normal reaction.